Hello again. I'm Alina Oprah, and since 23 years already ago, I'm dealing with FIDIC contracts. First, I was implementing FIDIC contracts, then I became an adjudicator and an expert in claims and a FIDIC trainer. Now, I will tell you something about the engineer. The engineer in FIDIC 99, FIDIC Red Book, FIDIC Yellow Book 99. As you know, FIDIC gave to the engineer a big role in the FIDIC contracts. The engineer is not signing a work contract, but it is part of the employer's personnel and is playing a big role in implementing the FIDIC contract. The FIDIC works contract or design and build contract is signed by the employer and by the contractor, and the engineer is defined as being part of the employer's personnel, and he plays the role that is given to him within the FIDIC clauses. This I have here the FIDIC in Romanian language that I have in English language. So the engineer plays the role that is given to him throughout the clauses of the FIDIC books. In issuing, in doing these responsibilities, in fulfilling his responsibilities, the engineer is meant to act on behalf of the employer. This is what FIDIC 99 says. And every action of the engineer cannot change the contract, and every approval or consent of the engineer will not exempt the employer or the contractor of their responsibilities under the contract. The engineer can also delegate his attributions to some of his assistants, so that whenever those assistants are acting according to their delegation that is made known to the parties to the contract, it will be considered that those attributions were fulfilled by the engineer itself. If a party is unsatisfied by the action of an assistant of the engineer to whom that specific responsibility was given, they can ask instruction or confirmation of the instruction, or even changing that instruction of that the assistant sent or gave under the contract. They can ask to the engineer itself. What else the engineer is doing as per the FIDIC contract? He is giving the instructions under the contract to the contractor. No one other than the engineer is giving these instructions. The instructions are given in writing, and whenever they are not in writing, the contractor should ask the engineer to confirm, to maintain, or to change if case the instruction, and the engineer will confirm if case that instruction in writing in 2 days. This is the only case in FIDIC 99 when the term, when the period of time for an instruction or something is 2 days and not a multiply of 7 days. Also, the engineer plays an important role in solving the claims of the parties, so that according to the clause 3.5 of the contract, the engineer will receive the claims of the parties, will analyze them, will make a consultation with the parties in order to get a consent, an agreement of the parties on that particular claim, and if not possible to get this agreement, then the engineer will make an engineer determination, a fair engineer determination. So under this subclause 3.5, an engineer's determination, the engineer is not acting on behalf of the employer, but he is judging, let's say, fairly the claim of either party, either of the employer, either of the contractor. So this is what, in a few words, the engineer, the magic engineer, is doing within the FIDIC contract. He's playing a lot of roles, and he has an important role in this FIDIC contract, and we should take care of him. If you want to see more videos about the FIDIC contract, you can subscribe to my channel and activate the notification of that bell there. And see you next time.